are down here at the library. I got some more books to show you this month, so let's get to it. So how far have you ever walked? Down the street? To a friend's house? To school? Well, I have a book all about walking. It's called Walking Towards Peace, the true story of a brave woman called Peace Pilgrim. Now, it's the story of this lady who, after the war, decided she wanted to do something to promote peace. So she changes her name to Peace Pilgrim, and she decides to walk across the country. Yes, she starts out right here in California, and she decides she's gonna map her journey across the country, meeting and talking to as many people as she can all about peace. She started at the Rose Parade in Pasadena one year, and she just kept walking over 25,000 miles. And after she was done, she did it again. So we can learn all about Peace Pilgrim's journey across the country and back again in our new book called Walking Towards Peace. Do you like puzzles and games? Well, how about puzzles and games in a book? Well, you can find it right here in our new early reader book, Bear and Friends. Where is Bear? Now, this is an early reader book, but kind of an early reader for our pre-readers who are just learning how to read. So it's super simple, nice, easy phonics that you're working on. Let's see, super bright pictures too, by the way. See, Bear can play. We can play. So you're working on those letter recognitions and those sounds, but there's something special about this book. Okay, so we're working on B because it's called Where is Bear? Bear starts with what letter? The letter B. So what's really great about this book is not only are you reading and learning your phonics, but you have to find the letter B that's hidden in each of the pages. I'll give you this one, but you'll have to check it out to find all the others. See right there? The letter B. So not only are you reading and learning your phonics, but you're trying to find the letters to help you identify them as well. And to top it off, at the very end, there's a really simple matching game you guys can do with your finger. Just match the word to the picture. How cool is that? All in one book. But don't worry, if you like this new phonics book, you'll like this one too. A House for Mouse. The exact same thing, but with the letter M for mouse. Here we go. Okay, my 5 to 8 year olds, have you guys ever seen the Goddess Girl series on our shelf and wish you could read it, but it's just a little bit too hard for you? Well, I've got a new series for you. It's called Little Goddess Girls. How cool is that? A whole series of Little Goddess Girls that's just like our big series of Goddess Girls. So this one is called specifically Aphrodite and the Golden Apple. Now it follows Aphrodite after she's rescued from her seashell. And she's trying to make friends, and she wants to go to Zeus, and she wants to ask for help in making friends. But along the way, she finds a golden apple. And there's something mysterious about that golden apple, and she kind of keeps it a secret from her friends. Well, why does she do that? You'll have to check it out to find out. Here we go. Super simple letters, helping. They're still kind of big to help you guys as you transition into your chapter books. We got some pictures along the way. Here we go. Some more writing, some more pictures, and what's even better is, yes, it has a word bank in the back, a word list of things that might be a little too hard as you read. You can just come to the back and it'll tell you what those words mean. Perfect, right? Here we go. Little Goddess Girls, Aphrodite and the Golden Apple. Okay, 8 to 12 year olds, I've got a great new chapter book. It's about 280 pages, so it is a little on the long side. It's called The House That Wasn't There. Now, this is a pretty interesting story because it follows two people who aren't really friends, Oak and Adler. Now, Oak moves next door to Adler, but her family cuts down the big tree that's between their houses, so Adler's not very happy. They're not getting off to a good start. They don't like each other, but something happens, something magical between their houses happens, and they might start becoming to be friends. This story is really great because each chapter kind of goes back and forth between Adler and Oak. So one chapter you'll be hearing Oak's thoughts and things going on in Oak's household. Then the next chapter, you're gonna go next door over to Adler's house and hear his thoughts and see what's going on in his house and see their journey as they become friends and the magic in between that helps out along the way. So here we go, the house that wasn't there. All right, I have a great new chapter book for my tweens, the 8 to 12-year-olds. It's about 270 to 280 pages. Here we go. It's called Show Me a Sign. Now, Show Me a Sign is an own voices book, which means it's based off of actual history and stories of the people who actually lived through what this book's going to tell you about. So this particular book follows Mary. Mary is descendant of a group of islanders from an island called Martha's Vineyard. Now, Martha's Vineyard, the people there, they can't hear. They're deaf. The same as Mary. She can't hear either. It's something in their community that they're all like that, which is fine. But the problem with this is that there's kind of an evil scientist who goes to the village, and he wants to find out, which it's great. He wants to find out why this community can't hear. But what's bad is that he doesn't go about it in the right way. So this is kind of Mary's journey and her history living on Martha's Vineyard, and the people around who are trying to study them and learn about them. Some do it right, some do it wrong. So here we go. We can learn all about them in Show Me a Sign. I have a great graphic novel for you guys. It's brand new. It's called Agent 9, Flood-a-geddon. Now this is Agent 9, and he does a pretty good job at being an agent. Might destroy things from time to time, but either way, at the end of the day, he always catches the bad guy. So in this particular graphic novel, Agent 9 is going up against King Crab. Do you know what King Crab wants to do? He wants to melt the polar ice caps in order to make a giant water park. Can you believe that? A giant water park. Well, it's up to Agent 9 to stop him. So we're going to see what he has to do in order to catch King Crab. He has some friends along the way to help him out. So here we go. Agent 9, Flood-a-geddon. Okay, friends, that's all we have for now. Don't forget, if you're interested in any of these titles, you can always place a hold at www.rivliv.net or give us a call and we'll help you out. Until next time.